I greet you with love. I greet you with peace. Today is another special day. And today we have a very incredible queen with us. We will be talking and discussing about the unspoken words of a woman. So I'll try to bring her in. It's an open discussion. Please share this video and try to invite your friends and family also. It's a new page and we are still trying to build the page. Yes. I'm just trying to share it. Help us share it also wherever you are. Help us share the message. The unspoken words of a woman. What does her silence really mean? Why do you have to care about her silence also? What does it mean for she to be silent? These things are very important to know. So I'm trying to invite Queen Alisa. Please, while we are waiting for her, please, if you are here, just write hello so I can see you. Then I can invite you. While we are doing that, please share the video. Share it to any group you have. Share it with your friends and family. Invite people to join us. It's a open discussion. To open discussion. Help us share it. It's very important that will create more and more awareness of this sacred feminine energy, which has been completely pushed aside, which has been completely ignored today. So the more we expand this, the more we raise this vibration, the more we can heal the mother hurts herself. So please help us share it and invite everyone. So many people. Oh, good evening. Good evening, Gina. Good evening, we. Please help us share it. I'm doing the same thing with my phone. is our soul food. Good evening, Jane. Good evening. Alisa, please, if you are here, you can write a comment so I can be able to bring you on board. Good evening, Amas. Good evening. Good evening, everyone. It's very wise to understand her silence. It's very wise to know why in some issues she just preferred to be silent. When you understand the mystical nature of a woman, then you will understand the secrets of her silence. Please help us share it. Good evening, Manasta. Good evening. Please share it. Hello, sunshine. You're welcome. Please help us share the video and invite friends and family also. While we wait for our guests, I'm trying to share the message to. Help us share it also. Oh, good evening, Raika. Nice to see you, my beloved brother. Nice to see you, King. I'm just trying to also share it to different places. When you understand why she keeps silence, when you understand the meaning of her silence, then you will understand why you should not ignore her when she is silent. Then you will understand why it's very important to engage her in a discussion. Then you will understand why and the meaning of those body language. It's very important. Good evening, my beloved brother, Abota Domo. Please share the video. I'm doing the same thing here with my phone. And soon our guests will come online. She's a writer, a filmmaker, a poet, and she's also an alchemist of love. She teaches love and practice love, of course. You have to always practice what you teach. That's when it makes more sense. Yes. Please help us share it. because a new page, so many people don't know I am live here, so I have to always be sharing it until everybody gets used to it. But the fact is, I share to a place I can't really share for everyone. Yeah, because then I have to spend so much time pressing and sharing. Please, if you are here, Miss Alicia, just write a comment so I can see you are here. Why it's beautiful to talk about these things is because today society we have. Write a comment and then I can add you on. Just have to press a comment. You can write hi or anything. Then I can see you. And then I can add you on. It's because today's society, so many people don't really understand the true nature of a woman, and this has made people be so quick to judge. When she talk too much. When she don't talk, okay, I have to call her because she's having some difficulties coming in. Hello, how are you? How are you? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Okay, if you are watching me right now, you can write a comment, then I can be able to bring you on board. Yeah. Okay, thank you. In today's society, I'm tired of sharing, so you can help me do the sharing. In today's society, so many people have completely misunderstand the real concept of a woman and how it's important to understand how she feel, how she talk, and how she express herself in a different way. And when you as a man or as a woman don't understand this.
Hello.
Hello. Good evening from you.
Hi. How are you?
I am fine, thank you. And you?
That is good. Let me get this situated.
Yeah, I have to do the same thing too. I'm using the phone. Mm-hmm. Okay, I can see you so well. How are you?
Oh yeah, can you see me? Can you hear me well?
Perfectly.
Awesome.
How are you feeling today?
I'm actually doing really good. No complaint.
That's nice.
So
that's nice. Yeah.
How are you? You look
I'm
good. You
always,
look well.
yeah, I'm always fine. I'm always fine. I'm doing so well. Lately, I've not been sleeping enough, but I am fine. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
That
Yes.
is that.
And today we're talking about the unspoken words of a woman.
Yes. Yeah, very, very interesting topic because as a woman, we hold a lot inside. Our brain is spinning 100 times faster than a man.
That's right.
So it's a gazillion words and a gazillion thoughts. Very interesting topic.
Yeah, that's right. So the way we are going to do it like is like this. It's an open discussion. It's an open discussion.
Okay.
And in this open discussion, you can feel free to ask me any question around this topic. And I can also ask you any question around the
Okay.
topic. You just give only the best of your insights of what comes from within you to express your own self.
Right. I'm with that. I can flow with that.
That's good. That's the
So what made you pick this topic? That let's start there. What made you pick
energy.
this topic?
Okay.
Hold that thought. Just get your thought. I'm gonna be right back. Don't move. I'm just gonna turn this air off so I can hear you a little bit
Okay,
better,
no
okay?
problem.
Just stay
No
right there.
problem.
Okay.
I'll wait so you can hear the answer. What made me choose this topic? Okay.
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 Now I can hear you much better.
Okay. For me, this topic is something very important. I choose the topic because I believe and feel it's time we let people in general understand that there is a language behind silence. And it's time humanity as a whole, regardless whether male or female, it's time we start paying attention to all those unspoken language. So because this page is mostly focusing on the feminine energy, so that's why I now name the topic Unspoken Words of a Woman. Because I know there is a language that you can bring into words. So that's
Yes.
why I chose the topic.
Okay. That is a How can I put that? That is a tall task to take on. And I'm sure you're going to have part one, part two, part three. Because the way, as a woman, the way we communicate sometimes is unspoken. And because our mannerisms line up with that unspoken words, that it forces someone to inquire, and then we can have a dialogue. But it takes that certain type of masculine energy to even appreciate someone that is in tune with those voices. You
Right,
understand what I'm saying?
perfectly.
Like, for an example, when you're dealing with your mate, and the communication is poor and is lacking. When a woman gets quiet, that brings more concern as to how fragile the relationship is. If a woman is talking and she's communicating and she's trying to convey what's working, what's not working, how we can fix it, and what do we need to do? We're going to go through all the details. We're going to go through A through Z. But it's when we become quiet and they call it leaving you slowly that our words now are sought after. But we've already had conversation. And if those items that we've talked about and nagged about are not addressed, then the relationship kind of severs itself.
Facts.
So it's like being in tune with yourself and in an alignment, so that even though you're having conversations and you're having thoughts and you're having these unspoken words, they have to be solid and valid, because you have so much transmitting through your mind that you have to be able to categorize it. Like, okay, is this my intuition, or is this some hidden fear or some triggers from past relationships that I am replaying in my head, and maybe these things are not happening. So you really have to be able to judge your own self before you even take a position. And that's where being in harmony with yourself and knowing your true self comes into play. And all of that energy kind of plays a part, because we get quiet when we're not getting the right amount of affection, the right amount of attention. If we're feeling disregarded or unimportant, we do get quiet to ourselves. We'll go about our daily business, but we're not our true essence.
Yes, right.
So you may get the cold shoulder, or you may not get that extra loving feeling that you normally would get, because deep inside, we're having all kinds of conversations, because that's how we're wired. We can do 10 things in a thought process. And like right now, I'm on this live with you. I have 5 other things that I'm already calculating
that's
to
natural.
Do.
That's beautiful.
And it's quite amazing, because I know your mission is to bring a light to the woman being God. And we're all God. It's just the feminine energy, although it doesn't come across as dominant, it's very dominant, because we control a lot of the universe.
Of course.
By our energy. But we need the masculine energy to balance it, because all feminine energy is not good either. We cannot, you know, it's like the sun and the moon. The moon, the sun is always shining. It's just the position that we're in.
That's right.
You know, but you need both. If you don't have the moon at night, we're done.
Right.
You don't have the masculine and feminine, and how they communicate is everybody's in a cycle.
Yes.
And you can't stop in the middle of the cycle and try to tell me to be the moon when I'm the sun. So that's where the roles are kind of like, everybody's doing whatever in a position of a masculine where you don't need to be there.
Yes.
You need to be in a feminine energy. And I think it's more of once you get in harmony with yourself, that unspoken word, that it will communicate easily, like almost like telepathy without words. And really the soul and the twin flames and the soulmates, they do communicate like that. I can feel it. And that's my take.
That's so beautiful. That's so beautiful. Because one of the things why I kind of like start this is because the present reality in the conscious self of this X right now that we have is not balanced. The masculine energy have kind of like not just only dominates, but also suppress the conscious self of the X. And there is too much people, whether men or women, is the same, because we all carry the both energies within us. But there is too much people always drafting towards the side of masculinity. Because the society today, for example, let's take an example of a single mother. She is more forced by the structure of the society to be more masculine instead of feminine, especially when she have a boy as a son at home. then the society already is like, you get a woman cannot raise a man. That's like the general saying, which is not true. She is a mother and she can raise both a man and a woman. But the balance right there is what she have to struggle with, because if not, she can really raise a man who end up becoming a sissy, because why? He has always
Exactly.
been around only feminine. So in that aspect, I can understand if a woman is trying to raise her masculine energy more than her feminine energy, depends on the situation or the scenario in her home. But in a general context, there is too much projection of this. Everybody have to be strong, hard. People see emotions as weakness today. And people see to be calm as something like you are not strong enough. It's okay if a man decides to just be relaxed. It doesn't mean he's a weak man. It means he's just relaxing. But today, as a man, you have to always kind of like show that masculine, I'm a man, before people will give you respect. If not, they just don't pay you too much attention.
They
And
overlook you. Exactly.
exactly. And that is because of the reality today. So when we relate this with unspoken words of a woman, it's very beautiful for we to let the world itself know that when a woman is not speaking, that doesn't mean she's scared. Actually, she's
Correct.
even talking more when she's silent. And
Exactly.
this language.
Because she's making, in that silence, she's making life transforming decisions versus going with the flow. She takes herself out of being a participant and she's more of an observer. So she becomes more reserved. And it's almost like becoming refined. You begin to act less and hold yourself back. And actually that does play an important part, even in communication, because as women, we can talk a mile a minute and a guy is only hearing a third
Yes,
of what we're
that's
saying.
right.
Like in my example, and I'm going to get to your point as far as raising a son, because I am a single mother of a son. But pointed an example of that is men tend to want a short version. Don't give me all the details. Give me the short version. But that's to a person that has communication issues. You follow what I'm saying? See, there's so many levels to that. A person that can't handle a lot, they just want cut and
Yes,
dry.
that's a time.
Versus a person that's in detail and they want to know, and they want to know all the details. So they ask you for it when you have the freedom, to do that. But that's more of a man like wanting the short version.
That's
But
fashion.
raising a son in this society, maybe because I'm older, I'm 50 and my son is 12, I've been through the phase of the demasculating the man. I was around when men were men, not homosexual influence, which I don't care. I'm not opposed to whoever you sleep with. I have no judgment.
Good.
It's just the influence. If he's born a man child, because that's what he is, if he has a penis, he's a man child because he will grow to be a man. Then there's certain mannerisms and an environment you have to be conscious of. I don't let my son watch me put on makeup. I don't let my son see me getting dressed all the time.
That's it, ma.
Now, I will make him help me. I will make him fasten my shoe, zip my dress, things that men
Good.
tend to do for their woman.
That's
But he doesn't watch me makeup, hair, and all this. No, keep him separate. He tried to play in my shoes, and I think all kids do that. And he actually got a spanking.
That's
So I
cute.
want him to know, you don't put my shoes
I
on because
love
you are a boy.
that. That's beautiful.
No, and I try to keep. I mean, and it's a vast task because you have to, even in your decor. I try to, because we have one bathroom. I try to keep that in neutral colors, not a lot of flowers, and not so he's not saturated with
Very
that. That
important.
he tends to, yeah, he wants that. I keep the colors, basic things like that. I keep his room. I don't make him be as particular. I mean, he has to keep it clean once a week, but regular, I mean, that's boyish. You don't want him being, oh, so particular, because that'll grow up in
Of
him
course.
and it'll shun him away from being masculine. Men like to get dirty sometimes, but then we never ever get dirty. Very challenging in today's society dealing with the masculine woman. There's more masculine women than there is masculine men.
That's
And
fact.
that's because here in America, I'll speak for America. I don't know too much about other places I've never visited. But here in America, a lot has to do with the slave trade. When they took the strength, the inner strength from the man, although we were there, we became stronger. The woman became
That's
stronger.
right.
We carried our families through the slave times. That became a part of our DNA to be strong like that, even though it's not our position. And it's hard to relinquish something that you've always had.
Facts.
So it's a matter of fear of letting the man be the man. Because you fear we're going to be back in a bad situation and I'm going to end up having to bail us out or whatever. But if you just let go, you can be the woman. And in being the woman, your energy automatically guides your family because you build your home.
That's right.
You decide what you eat most of the time because you're going to the market. You decide the activities in your house. You decide the decor. So your environment has a lot to do with the energy you project. If it's masculine, it's going to be masculine. And women just have a hard time letting that go. I'm not one of I can go back to the caveman days. I swear to you. My mom is the most submissive person that I know.
Wow.
My dad was the most alpha man that I know. So anything outside of that is foreign to me. And I
I
don't
love
feel I
that.
fit.
I love that.
I don't fit. So it's more too like how you was raised.
Yes.
It's a lot. I mean, there are so many layers to this unspoken word because a lot of women that are in masculine positions don't want to be masculine, but that's all they know.
That's true. That's true.
And the fear of reprogramming your mind, not so much as change. Sometimes we talk about change, people don't want to change. Life changes you regardless if you want to or not. When it's winter, you cannot wear summer clothes. There's repercussions to that. So you will change with the seasons.
That's facts.
We have an issue with transformation. How do you transform yourself? How do you reprogram yourself to be that feminine energy that guides you and really guides the world? Because you can always tell, and I know the story of Oshun a little bit, but when she left the scene, everything was chaos.
That's facts.
And they came back to her, begging her, we want love. We need this energy. This world right now is suffering because of the lack of ocean's energy, which is love.
Yes.
Is unspoken at its highest because it's unconditional. But when it's taken for granted, it's not that love changes, but love goes away and love reflects on itself. And that's, we do that as women as well. That's that when I'm fed up, there's no more talking. I'm not even here. I don't exist to you, remember? You don't want me.
Mm-hmm.
Until you see life without the feminine energy. And that's what we see now. That's what we see in America.
In the world.
Everything that's going on is because there's no woman. And right now, we have a black vice president candidate. She's mixed. She's Jamaican and from India. That's still black. Yeah. That's still a woman of color. So, and I'm not like, you know, prophetically speaking, but if you're vice president and something happens to the president, you become president.
Yes.
And I think her energy is what is needed. Hillary was too masculine.
Hillary, yeah. She was the boss.
You see the difference? She's very masculine. She would not fit. That's why she didn't win.
Yeah.
Kamala, Miss Harris, very feminine. She knows her position. She's a wife. She's a mother. She's going to be what America needs to try to repair all of this damage from all of these years.
Yeah.
There's been no woman in charge.
Yes. And that is a sign of a hope. But that hope needs to really be guided so we hope we were having when we saw Obama. You know, Obama gave the world hope, especially we in Africa. Obama was like the Messiah in our hearts and our eyes that came back. But after we saw it, never did like nothing for us in Africa. And so
nothing.
My own kind of...
So imagine how we feel.
Yeah, of course. My own kind of concern is if the real intention of the feminine energy within her is hacked and manipulated, then that can really be also a destruction. Then instead of Oshun, it's like we're having Oya.
And the thing is, because of her DNA, she has no choice but to be feminine.
That's where we have to work
because
on.
Indian women, exactly, because Indian women are very feminine but strong.
Yes.
They balance the femininity and the masculinity within them. Mm. They're very strong women.
Yes.
Very, you know, actually the company that I work for, they're Indians.
Mm.
So the culture of Hinduism is feminine.
It's feminine.
The arts of sexuality is feminine.
Yes.
All of that is going to play. Father is Jamaican. We can't lose because of the history of Jamaica.
Yes.
She's got all of that inside of her.
Mm-hmm.
So I have a lot of hope.
Yes, it's good.
That we are seeing a change in the atmosphere as far as the feminine energy.
Yes, and that's what I love inside, because it is just like Ethiopia now. Ethiopia have completely reshuffled all our cabinets. Everybody now is women, because wise and smart people start understanding our secrets. And the secret is, if this divine sacred feminine energy is what governs at least 80% of the universe, then the more we connect this energy down here on earth, the more we heal the mother earth, and the more we raise the vibration of this earth ourselves. if we operate more in a feminine energy, especially those in authorities, then we will have more peace around the world. Then we have more like a more unified society that is better than today. I can't imagine a table full of 15 generals and they are all men. I can't imagine that type of energy around a table like that. But if you have like 15 generals and 10 are women, the senior ranks, it's a different reality. And this is why I love so much.
Totally different.
Yes. This is why I love so much more and more feminine energy in politics, in business, in movies. I like them to come in more so their voice can really be heard more. But like now, talking about the unspoken words, how can, like you're a woman, so this is like a question, open question for you.
Okay.
How can a man understand those unspoken words? Let's say a woman is sitting and he say, are you okay? She don't reply. What are you want something? She don't reply. You want to eat? She don't reply. So how can, I know how, but I just want you to also explain it. How can a man really understand that unspoken language in between there?
That goes into the realm of sexuality.
Mm.
Because as long as I am in this third dimensional, you know, the flesh, the get up and meet my obligations and protect my home, those words are sitting there dormant, but they're not like they're not speaking.
Mm.
They're just dormant. It is when you connect with your mate or the person that you're seeing that that energy speaks for itself.
Mm.
And those conversations happen before intercourse, during intercourse, and after intercourse, because it opens that communication that's in a different realm. Because when you're intimate, well, for me, when you're intimate, that shuts off the world. That shuts off your obligations. We're not thinking about bills. We're not thinking about the car needs to be fixed. We're not thinking about the pandemic. We are two souls. And whatever is bothering me or affecting me, even if, because I feel the world's pain.
Yeah.
You know, so many nights I lay up and cry for no reason, but I know the reason is because of what's going on in the world.
Yes.
And I can't help it. I just can't absorb it into me to contaminate me, but I feel it physically. And it's when you're during that sacred time, and it doesn't always have to be intercourse. It could be just you two laying, listening to the crickets.
That's fine.
That opens up that realm that those unspoken words begin to speak.
Mm.
And it doesn't hurt when you are struggling with that. It doesn't hurt to bring in what they call them, conduits. Like some people have wine. Some people engage in cannabis, you know, marijuana.
Mm-hmm.
Those type of conduits, they help bring the body down. That's why they call them spirits. It subdues this third dimensional thinking, and it takes your real mind
out
to the forefront.
Yeah.
So you can communicate like that. I communicate like that all the time. I've often... This is not embarrassing. I'm just kind of shy.
No, I
often have conversations during intercourse, and the person has actually responded vocally. Like, you heard me? And I know I didn't open my mouth to say
that's beautiful.
And it was very shocking because they answered me.
Mm-hmm. It's like that.
And so I know that exists. I just don't tap into it as much as I should. Because then though that unspoken word, because that's a language that, because we're always misunderstood, sometimes we don't even want to talk about what we really, really feel, those unspoken words, until it becomes a conflict. See, we're good at bringing everything out when it's a conflict and we want to confront you about something. But just your everyday, when you wake up, when you go to bed, we just keep it to ourselves because we're always misunderstood because of the environment. So it takes that both. I want to hear what's going on. I want to know how you're thinking. So that way, I can communicate with you better.
That's right.
Guys, don't always think like that. It takes that extra guy, the extra mile. And just as if there's not, it, just as if there's a, not a lot of feminine women, there's not a lot of alpha masculine men that's willing to listen. Sit on the couch, baby. Put your feet up. Tell me what's going on. You don't have that. You used to, but now we have so much technology that absorbs our time and our energy that we forget about the human being relationship. We'd rather be on social media gassing up other people who we don't hardly even know.
Yes.
So we'll make sure we like their pictures, we comment, but the human being that you are in right here, they're left by the wayside because of technology.
Yes.
So if it's it's like we take off layers and then we add layers. Because before the shift happened where the woman is not as feminine as she used to be, we didn't have social media. She was all feminine. She had to She had to keep house. We didn't have a lot of fast food restaurants. So as we evolve into technology, as a being, we have to evolve as well. I get so irritated by the lack of communication when we have 1,000 apps to communicate. We don't even have to be on social media. We can download an app. I think it's called Telegram. One of those apps. We communicate through that way. Pictures, videos, all that. You can pick one. So for you to have a lack of communication to where a woman would have to have an abundance of unspoken words, then that means that there's just no communication at
all. Exactly.
And that fuels the feminine energy.
Yes.
Because we create communication.
Yes.
We create that. Men are mostly responders. So we just have to figure out a way to tie in everything, but yet keep it simple for human interaction. I don't want to be a robot. I hate checking the box, are you a robot? I am not a robot. Like, how would you know if I wasn't? But I'm not a robot. So we can't treat each other like robots. We have to understand, and how we do that is through the feminine energy. She has to surrender that masculinity.
That's right.
Because I'm not taking charge of a relationship. I'm not doing that. I don't want a pat on the back. I'm not doing it. You will be a man if you're going to be with me.
That's right. I love that. I love that. I love that. Because why I love that
point. Women have to relinquish that. Yeah, it's huge because we... I don't say I'm the only person that feels like this. That would be too absolute. But it's very few of us. Like, I struggle with my girlfriend that I hang with and we talk. And they're talking about something off the wall. And I'm sitting here like, Well, that's not how we're going to move forward. Our generations will be warped. If all the women are masculine, then what are the men going to do? Be feminine? God forbid.
God forbid.
God forbid.
This is what I always share with people. This is why I don't subscribe to some of these feminist movements of today. I subscribe more with the ancient feminist movements, because then it was more deep connected to nature and spirituality. But today, a lot of so-called feminist movements, they are not trying to balance it. They are trying to take over and be in charge. And what they are simply doing is transforming a woman into a man. And that's not what we need.
And that can never happen.
It can never work like that. A man got to be a man. A woman has to be a woman and be respected and treated as a woman.
If they really push with the feminine movement, we would be at a more advantage. They're trying to make an equal. We're not equal.
Cannot be.
See, once they get the concept out, see, I'm okay with some feminists, with the equal pay and like that
that's
kind of
cool.
stuff.
That's
okay
normal.
Yeah, that's normal. But the reality is, men stand up to use the bathroom, women sit down. We're not equal.
That's fact.
Women have babies and their bodies need to rest for 6 weeks. That's mandatory.
Yes.
Whether you feel like you can go back to work or not, your body needs 6 weeks to recover. Even though men should be allowed to be home during that time with the newborn, their bodies don't. Nothing's happening to their body.
Yes.
They can go to work.
Of course.
They should have the option to choose. So you know what I'm saying? They're not being fired or disciplined or being wanting to be home with a newborn baby. But we're not the same. Now, if I'm doing the exact same job as you, then we should be paid the same. But women sell themselves short because some women have cramps so bad that they have to take time off from work for their cramps. We're not equal.
Exactly.
So it seems like that it's like it's you hitting at a net and swallowing a fly. Protest for rights to have longer than 6 weeks. Protest for rights to have time off for a monthly period. Those are the kind of women rights that I'm for. Because sometimes your body don't want to get up to go to work. I'm a woman. I'll take a $3 pay difference because I'm going to need that in my benefit to take days off.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? The negotiation of that. Like, okay, we can pay $20 an hour, but guess how many days I'm going to take off from work because I'm having horrible cramps. The guy standing next to me looking like she getting paid to be off because she on her period, but we getting paid the same and I'm standing here. Well, what ailment can I have every month to have a couple of days off? But until we begin to think like a female and go for those rights that equate to a female, who cares what you make? I mean, who really cares?
Exactly. Just like how somebody,
when you start adding up how many times you take off.
Just as like somebody commented, she said, we need balance, not equality. And that is so true.
Yes, and but see, the thing with the feminist movement here that messed us up as Black women, we got on board with the white feminists when they just wanted our votes.
Yeah.
There were no benefits for the black woman. None. In fact, they put us all on welfare, said, we're going to help you out. We're going to give you welfare. But here's the kicker. You can't have the father in the house.
That's right.
And we fell for it, thinking that we're going to help our, because we're going to still let the man come and live, spend the night. But he can't be there. He can't live there. He can't reside there. So you put the man on the outside of a home.
Yeah.
How did that help the black family?
There's no.
That's why that 90% of the black women are single with kids. Because before, when you had a kid, it was almost an expectation to be married, to build a household for that child. Now, women are having kids just to get welfare.
That's right.
Just to get that government money, generational
you
welfare,
keep saying it.
Which over time destroys the feminine energy. Yes. Because if I'm the head of my household, in my mind, I'm the head of my
yes.
house. You come over here when I say come over here, and you leave when I say leave. That's masculine.
That's masculine. And the longer a woman stay alone, the more our masculine energy increase, because you have so many women today. Let's say since 15 years, she has always been alone. So our house is like our kingdom. When even she brings a man home, she has to tell the man where to sit, where to put shoes, where to stand, and when to shower, when not to use the shower. That already always projects that masculine energy towards the man. And then she wonder why the man never stay with her. So every 2 weeks, she have to always get a new man, because she is a man now. And when she gets frustrated in
here's the flip side. And she's stressed out about
exactly.
it. But she created
exactly.
that. She created
exactly.
and don't know how to get out of it. Because fear will hold you in a toxic situation.
Facts.
Because you're afraid of the future.
Facts.
When the unknown is the most creative place you can be. Because you know what you have right now. But here's the flip side to that. You have someone like me, submissive, homemaker, ready to be, you know, I've been married twice. Both relationships, my first relationship, too young. I didn't know what I was doing. Second relationship, 40, married. Narcissist. He didn't know what to do with a woman like me. He thought he could just take over me because I was submissive. Not knowing.
Speak like that.
The feminine spiritual energy in me say, no. You got some issues. You need to work out. I'm gonna exit over here and let you figure that out. And I'll just be by myself for a while.
Yeah.
We'll work it out. But you have the flip side of men that has never been around submissive women. They don't know what to do.
Yeah.
They were themselves as men were raised in a single mother household, and they didn't get along with their mother because, again, it's only so far. Like, my son is 12. It's only so far I can get with him.
Yeah.
Then he's going to shut off because then he's going to be into girls. So he's on an accelerated path. Like, I got to dump all this into you now. But most men don't know how to handle a woman that is submissive. Or feminine.
Yeah.
We get taken advantage of all the time.
Yes.
So that also
molested.
I said this and I wrote a piece about it. Love is the ultimate sacrifice.
Yes.
And
frequency.
You have to be willing to go against society, the world. It's like you against the world. The world say, don't love like this. Don't be like this. T- Times have changed. Move with the times. But if we all move with the times, oh my goodness. If we think it's chaos now,
this is nothing.
If no one ever held up the sanctity of marriage or monogamy, I mean, some people are into polygamy. That's a whole nother series. I ain't with polygamy. One woman, one man.
Yeah, that's good for you.
I can't handle nothing else. But somebody, and I love you for the work that you do. I really do. I've been following you now for years.
Thank you.
And it's like somebody has to keep sounding the alarm, keep dropping the seed. They will grow. You know, you drop some seeds, you can't sit there and watch it. It won't grow overnight, but it will grow.
Definitely.
Love in the end will win. We will win. And this divine masculine, divine femininity, we will win.
Yes.
Because the world is going to collapse. It's collapsing
it's
now.
It's breaking now. It's breaking now.
Listen, they're killing us. Like it is open season, like we are in the jungle.
Yes.
They shot that man 7 times. Like we're in a jungle. That is the absence of love. That is the absence of balance. That is the absence of harmony. And the only way to get that back is platforms like what you have right now.
Thank you so
because
much.
Somebody's gonna take that. Somebody's gonna take what you're saying, take what we're saying collectively. And they're going to go home and transform themselves. Like, I can be feminine. It's okay. It's more beautiful than anything because you're really, like you say, more godlike than
That's
man.
Facts. That's facts. Yeah. That's facts.
Yeah. And we raise the children. So, you know, even though your children may be grown, it's still, as long as you're breathing, you still can transform.
Yes, exactly.
Have to do within your circle. Work on you, then work on your family, then work on your friends, and it will spread.
That's just how it is. Like I was discussing with someone this afternoon, we should stop worrying about saving the world. That's not the goal. We have to be safe, then our light cannot illuminate the path of those that connect with us. And that's how we can collectively be saving each other. Then the whole world will become safe. Because where we just run out there, want to save everything, we will end up losing ourselves. And at the end, we can't really do nothing.
And you feel defeated.
Yes.
Defeat is an emotion that will gridlock you to your position. It will... When you fail, it takes so much to get up. So if you have a huge fall trying to save the world when all you really need to do is save yourself.
Exactly.
That's it. You hit it. You nailed it. You can't save the world because it's impossible. But you can impact the world.
That's right.
Because we're all connected. So everything that you do, even what you're doing now, these vibrations in the middle of the day, they're going out in the airway.
Exactly.
You know, and then when the intent and the heart is right and it's alignment, I'm supposed to be working right now. I took off. I said, I deserve a break. You know, you can't work 9 hours straight. So I said 2 o'clock. You know, I had some technical difficulties trying to get this set up, and I was like, I'm taking a break. It'll be there. This is important to me. This platform, this opportunity to be with you and talk to you, you know.
Thank you.
I would do it in a heartbeat, knowing that it could change our environment. It could change
exactly.
our world, you know. Our
exactly. Exactly. We are
so
just
I'm
trying
welcome.
To play.
Thank you.
Thank you, too. Thank you. It's always... Since years now we know each other, it's always been so beautiful. And I'm always grateful for our divine connection. What I want to say is another thing that's really behind this intent is
I need your consent on a few items to continue.
my phone is talking to herself. I don't ask you anything. These are the things we talk about. Robots controls everything now. Because they
Exactly.
hear me say something and then she will just talk back
Right.
to me. I'm not talking to her, I'm talking to her. Yes,
Exactly.
that's what we're talking about. So, what I want to say is one of the intents behind this, because a lot of people always get kind of, what are you saying? My woman is God, man is a worshiper. Who is lesser, who is higher? But people don't, not everybody, some people don't really understand the nature of a God and the real nature of a worshiper. A worshiper is not a slave. And another word for
Correct.
worship is honor, acknowledgement. That's why my book is come,
Adoration.
yes, appreciation. That's why my book is coming out to really break all this down very soon. Because it
Oh,
is
good.
time, the only hope for humanity is for we to embrace this divine feminine energy. That does not mean we are pushing the masculine side because it's yin and yang, it's balanced. But what we are doing right now is because of the imbalance already in today's society, it's time to raise this sacred feminine energy. For example, in Germany have laws that kind of like transform women into a man, which means from the day she kick you out of her house, she become rich because she gets more
Oh,
money.
wow.
Yeah, she get more money, child support, everything like times two comparing to when she's with a man. So a lot of women now don't even tolerate a mistake of a man, which is natural. Mistakes are natural. But now, because of the way the society are structured, it makes so many women easily to take decision, hey, take your bag, get out of my house. When he don't go pick up her phone and call the cops, is out on the streets. And from the next month, her paycheck increase, me giving her more reason never to allow him back. It doesn't stop there. Then the system also will breed her now to now become the man. And that
Right.
is still masculine energy. So when
Correct.
some people hear us talk about increasing and raising the sacred feminine energy, they always just shining it to a woman. It's not just a woman. A man and woman will both carry these energies, and raising it is
Correct.
something that needs to be raised in a man and also raised in a woman. For
Yes.
example, so many men believe it's a weakness to cry as a man. Because of that, their emotions are all stuck in them. They are things they are supposed to just express and don't feel shame about expressing it. They let it stuck with them.
Correct.
And then that stuck emotion easily transform into anger. So they're always like abusive to their wives or aggressive. It's because too many stuck emotion and he's in a world where you have to always demonstrate he's strong. No, take a break, man. Abduct more of that feminine nature. Look for someone and just put your head in her shoulder and say, please, I need a hug. It is normal. There's so many men believe if they ask you for a hug, it means they are weak. And that is the absence of the feminine nature within them. Same with a woman. So we have so many women who believe that I must have the highest paycheck before I can meet the natural standard of big women or classic women in the society. But it is okay to just be able to take care of your bills, have something to get whatever little things you need, and be happy.
Correct. I agree
All
with
women must not have a diamond ring, diamond earrings, $100,000 car. Yes, it's good, but when your reality is not so, be happy and satisfied. So bringing and introducing more of this feminine energy into today's society is what I see as the priority now. That is one of the reasons for
Yeah.
this platform, because this is the only hope left for humanity today.
It really is. I agree 100% because men do have estrogen. They do have feminine hormones. And if they're dormant or being suppressed, that comes out negatively in the body, health-wise as well. We all should be able to cry. We all should be, I mean, we have tears, we have emotions, we're human. And for a man to feel weak, or the society to make him feel weak for crying, is like an injustice. Because you want him to be abnormal, but function normally. Like there's so much pressure on a man, especially the black man. Literally, the weight of the world is on his shoulders. And it's when he gets in touch with both sides of himself, do he become the divine masculine
That's correct.
that complements the feminine energy? And it's no longer, like you said, worship in as in the form of idolatry, but it's more so understanding this human. When you can understand a woman because you yourself understand feminine energy, that communication is like, man, it's like the ocean. You know what I'm saying? Not like a little pond or a stream. It opens it up like the ocean because then now you can communicate with me. And the one element of all humankind is communication. If we lose communication, we have nothing. And right now, we're on the brink of no communication. Like, you don't understand me. I don't understand you. I'm going to do it this way, whether it's wrong or right, and I don't care what it's going to do down the line. Not understanding that when you go against the blueprint of something, yeah, it may work, but it won't work for long, and
For sure.
it's going to be so much greater damage to fix, like where we at right now. This is, it's still repairable, it's still hope, but we're on that edge where it could just, and everybody's just up in shambles. No relationships, no commitment. Everybody's sleeping with everybody. So forget about one-on-one. Just join the crowd. And you'll have this little sect of people like me sitting somewhere like, do y'all see what's going on in the world? Like, I cannot believe it. I'm so. Sometimes I really do. People say you may not be from here. Like I really think I'm from another planet. Really, I do. Like, because I never ever connect with none of the mindsets, none of them.
Especially in
I don't
America.
connect with the same sex. I don't connect with transgender. I don't. I've learned, evolved, I would say, and I'm very proud. I've learned to take out my judgment.
That's
I
wisdom.
don't care what you I cannot call you a woman unless you're getting a period every month.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? So it's little things like that. That's the feminine energy. Like, I'm insulted as a woman when a man that's born with a penis can have a cosmetic, just cosmetic, eyebrows, breast implant. You can look like a woman. And you want me that was born a woman. Like, you want to force me. That's like blasphemy. to the feminine energy. And I'm okay with you wanting to look like a woman. Mm-hmm. There's nothing wrong with you wanting to look like a woman. There's nothing wrong with you dressing like a woman. Do what you want to do. But don't say you are me. We're not the same.
Exactly.
Listen, I've been, and you know, sometimes, you know, people hear menstruation or cycle or period. That's the most sacred time of a woman.
That's right.
That's right.
That's the alignment with the universe.
But it's sacred. Yes. We're preparing our body every month to bring life, whether life happens or not. Our bodies is on a cycle, just like the stars and the moon and the eclipse and the full moon. And we cycle.
Yes.
So unless you are getting that,
You're not a woman. That's right.
And there are women who don't cycle. But they're women that have a medical problem or issue or deficiency. Correct. Yes. Some people say, well, all women don't get periods. Okay. But they're still a woman. They can get an implant and carry a baby.
Mm-hmm. The womb is there.
So it's like we have to continue this mission, you know, weekly, monthly, to get it out. You know, your posts is so inspirational. And I know sometimes you get people on your post questioning you. I've seen them, you know, you have some fanatic Christians, you know, don't understand the essence of worship.
Yeah.
Like, I gave birth to my son. I am his God, basically.
Of course. That's right.
Okay. It would bring me no less pleasure. It would bring me all the pleasure for him to grow up and adore me or adore his wife. That is the goal. Like, there's nothing wrong with that. You can even rule over me. My son will one day have to rule over me. He will have to be the executor of my estate. He would have to tell them her last will and testament. Yeah. We relinquish that power to humanity, to our children, to our mate.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing wrong.
Nothing wrong.
We're giving birth to your kingdom. He can rule over me because a real feminine wouldn't. That's what she wants, even though she's the creator of that.
That's facts. That's facts.
And she will sit there like a queen, and that's what she wants. She wants that.
I love that.
That to me is the essence of God. We create.
Exactly. Exactly.
And we have a purpose of why we create.
Exactly.
There's nothing more beautiful than a man and a woman. I'm sorry. When you put them two together, you see the Big Bang Theory happen all the time. You create universes after universes after universes.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm all for feminine. I'm all for the unspoken word and making that unspoken word vocal. So it's that gap that we have to focus
exactly.
on.
Exactly. That gap is so important because one of the reasons that so many women have unspoken word in today's reality is the continuous kind of demonization of our speech, of our words. Let's take sexual energy, for example. So many men on earth, when a woman say, I want to make love, come, let's go to the room. So many men always misinterpret that. They view the woman as something like spoiled, corrupt, prostitute. They prefer him to always be the one to say, hey, babe, come. Let's go. So that's act of demonizing what she's saying, judging and criticizing what she always say already, we create those unspoken words. So
absolutely.
She can now be horny, for example. She can't say it out because she know a man will rebuke her. Yes, she if she's so smart, she cannot try to wear like attractive things and try to flirt around without being able to say it out vocally. That's just like one
right.
aspect. That when it comes to like in the work sector, there are so many companies, they believe because you are a woman already, your strength is limited. You can't do what a man can do. So, about when you always complain about your fellow male workers, or the when you always complain about your fellow colleagues who are male, maybe because they are disrespecting you or they don't speak to you with a nice way, there's always this, ignore her, she's a woman. Women talk, always complain, talk too much. And because of that demonization and critics, it helped, it now make, she can be in that company, being disrespected, being not respected, and she can just, because she don't want to lose the job, and stop complaining, because everybody say she's complaining, that she was not really complaining, she was just speaking out what need to be spoken, her mind. And this imbalance in today's reality, it's so much. We can give like hundreds of examples of all this imbalance, even in marriages. You make perfect examples about relationship. All this needs to really be addressed, and people have to know that expression of self is the most beautiful art of respect. And people have to really know the real meaning of respect. Accepting people's limitation, that is respect. So it should not be a problem for me if you are expressing yourself, and I should be patient enough to listen. The art of listening is wisdom, is intelligence, it's learning. That today's society, people are always quick to like, I know what you want to say. You know what? Don't worry, I'll fix it. No, you don't know what she wants to say. Let her finish saying it. Because that words is a vibration and it needs to be released, regardless whether you agree with her or not, but just let it come out. So those unspoken words can create like a cancer within her and can start damaging her kidney, her liver, and damaging her pancreas, because these energies are not coming out. And some women will start having sore throats, like they can't speak, their throat is cracked, because that chakra there is stuck. A lot of things, the emotions and the body, everything is stuck. When she's even in a period, it shows that in this month, you have stuck energies, because a lot of women, when they have period, it's always manifest how they are being treated during that month, during that cycle. And all this manifests in that when she's having a menstrual fluid, a menstrual bleed, all this manifests. But when she is able to freely, really express herself, regardless whether the man or the people agree with her or not, because you don't have to agree to everything I say. But I should be able to say it. And this is something we are trying to pass out there for people to know it is okay to listen to what she has to say. Because when you don't make a listen, it's like you open a grenade and you put it inside a cup and put the cup under your armpits. It will explode later. And when it when it later explodes, then it's a disaster.
Yeah, it is. I've experienced that. I've been in situations where I have been suppressed to express my feeling to the point where I choose not to, and then I make you feel the unspoken word. Then you want to know what's wrong with me. Then you want to know what's on my mind, because as long as I'm talking and express, everything comes into alignment because you have my communication. You know where I'm at. It's when you tell me, give me the short version. Now, I'll be one to admit, I have to, things that you can work on as far as communication. My personality type is I repeat myself as if to presume you don't understand. Whereas if I just say it the one time and be done with it, I'm practicing that. Because I always feel like I have to repeat myself. Like, do you understand me? Like, let me say it in a different way. But I don't have to do that. Exactly. I just presume that I am misunderstood. That takes, I mean, you have to be able to critique yourself. Yes. And that's one of the things that, and I feel rushed when someone say, okay, give me the short version. Because I am a writer. So it's hard for me to take the writer hat off and put on a human, like a regular human. Yeah, what's a short version? I don't know a short
version. I can't say my
life. I have to give you all the, I have to give you all the detail. Like a story, but everything doesn't have to be in a story. So even in communicating, we have to take ownership of who we are also talking to, their past, their life, how they were raised. How were they, I think I posted it. How were you loved? You know, were you always rushed? Did your mother hug you every day and kiss you in the morning and ask you how was your night? And do you have any bad dreams or good dreams? If you're not used to getting that, when you get with somebody that's like that, that would be irritating. Because, like, do you have to talk like that every day? We have to talk every day. We live every day,
so
right?
We must speak every
we
day.
We all have the same 24 hours. So it's just, it's so many different categories. Like, even though you want to communicate, you have to know who you're communicating with.
That's right.
And that's where sometimes communication get lost in translation because you're not hearing anything that I say because you don't, you have already tuned me out. You only heard I want to see you.
Yes.
You didn't hear the date, you didn't hear the time, you didn't hear anything that I had to do, and I've given you all of that. So then when you decide in the middle of the day, oh, I don't want to do that, and you don't communicate that back, but you have it in your head, that's not what you want to do. There's a conflict.
Yeah.
There's a huge argument there. Because it's like, I told you what I wanted to do. You had no resistance or anything. So guess what? Now we're in a place of unspoken words. Now you have to feel me. Because it seems as if whatever I say, you ain't listening. So now you have to pick it out. So sometimes women, we get like that too. We get to a place where we're not being heard. There's no platform for us to talk. We talk all the time.
Yes.
In our head, in our spirit, vocally. We be on the phone, raising kids, on the phone, working. That's just how we're wired. And unless you appreciate that, because guess what? I can take care of something for you. You can ask me to call AAA and figure out how to get your car towed. I can do that tight. It's good when it's convenient for you.
Yes.
But when it's not appreciated.
Yes.
So we have to learn to appreciate our qualities and differences.
Wow.
I know men only with the short version. I'm learning. I'm practicing.
We are all students of the universe, so we are all learning every day. Yeah.
But listen, I do have to go back to the clock.
We have tried a lot, and I so much thank you. So what we got to do is we have to, from time to time, whenever you're free, I can always invite you, and we can always do it.
Yes, please.
Yeah,
do.
I really appreciate you, and today is really a blessing, like always.
Yes, it is. I feel honored. So, thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, I thank you for being here, and I appreciate you being here. Thank you so much, and I wish you and the family a nice day ahead.
Bye to your audience.
Bye bye.
Okay.
Send you peace and love.
Take care.
Okay. Bye bye for now.
Okay.
Oh, so beautiful. Today we'll be stopping in here because it's more than normally. We want to be keeping it at least 1 hour 20 minutes, so it's not so long. So, but today we'll be stopping it here. And tomorrow, we have a wonderful guest. We will be discussing about the mother hurts and how to heal yourself just by connecting with the mother hurts. Don't forget, woman is God, and the earth herself is a conscious being of our own self. So when you connect with that sacred mother, it's very purifying. And we'll be discussing all this tomorrow with our incredible guest. And I will see you all tomorrow. I thank you all for being here today. This is just the beginning. More and more and more and more we'll be doing this. Incredible, incredible people will be coming. We'll be doing this. Please, all you have to be doing for us is help us share it, create the awareness, help us share it. It's a new page, so we want it to grow and want to flood the air with knowledge. So always share it for us. I wish you a nice day, and bye-bye for now. Bye-bye.